Everybody, here we are to some battling of some games. I'm David McDarby, joined with
Justin Parnell.
And we're doing some commander battling. Thank you for multiplying your cube decks by 2.5 and joining me here in this arena. Yep, so we're going to have a.
A little rough, like I said. A little tough to shuffle 100 cards, not used to that, but.
I mean, you know, we'll join the big leagues, boy.
Yeah, I know.
So here we go. We're going to have some 4-7 battles. Let's roll three dice.
Three dice?
Huh. Yeah.
All right.
I like. Okay, all right. I roll double, so I roll again.
Okay.
11. You get all three dice.
All right.
You rolled 5.
All right, so let's see. So we have 15.
Yep, you got me.
All right, excellent.
Yep, excellent.
All right, I will play first.
Sure, the pandas can have all the handicap they need to defeat the squirrel empire.
The squirrels aren't getting none on the pandas. Look, they're so nutty in their
They have to have us to breed them. They're dying on their own.
All right, that's enough. He's playing in water. What do you have to say about that?
He's not playing, he's drinking it.
He's playing.
No.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right.
I have a pregame effect, sir.
Oh my pre-game gosh.
Effect. Chancellor of the Spires, please reveal the top 7 cards of your library and put them into your graveyard. Yes. 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 No. No.
No!
Yes! All right. There's one card that I can cast so far. Vampiric Tutor off that guy.
All right.
Continue on.
Am I ready? More pregame effects?
Well, you're at 83 cards left in your library.
I'll pass.
But 83,
turn.
I mean 85. I don't know. Hey, I drew my cohort. There he is. I will play Draw Isle Refuge. I will gain a life.
One life.
41, you're up. If I live at one life, you'll know who to thank.
That's right. I will pass the turn.
Yeah, that's right. Ooh, I like that guy. I will play Menomino. Do do.
Menomino.
There you go. Mindstone. Menomino. Right.
Mindstone's pretty good.
Do do do.
All right. We'll keep the basic lands rolling.
How many basic lands do you have in your deck?
Well, at least one mountain and one swamp. Mm. I'll pass the turn.
Yeah, that's right. You will. Give me time to get my engine rolling.
Go ahead. Get them rolling.
I will pay 3 mana and cast Worn Power Stone.
He's ramping, ladies
It may
and
be old, but it's still a goodie. I will play Tulare D. West. Shout out to my homies.
Sounds good.
Here you go.
All right. We need some kind of action. Some kind of action. Little light on the action still.
Mm-hmm.
We'll just play a land, and
what are you doing over there?
We're going to pass the turn yet again.
Excellent. Strong. Strong play. Mm. Strong play. Hmm. Hmm. I will play a land. And I will play the one card that you know that I have in my hand. Chancellor of the Spires.
Now, what does this even do?
It is pretty much Diluvian Primordial, except it doesn't exile the card. Everyone knows what that
cast
card does.
Cast target right? Instant or sorcery.
I will cast Vampiric Tutor.
You don't want to cast Temple of Vengeance.
I choose not to cast that one.
I know it's tempting.
It is tempting. I will cast Vampiric Tutor.
It does not exile it, so it's going to sit in my graveyard.
Mm-hmm. And I will get... What will I get? You can go ahead and go.
Okay.
I think I know what I want to get. It's either this guy or the other one. This guy. This guy sounds fun. I'll get this guy.
Okay. That was a pretty good draw. So, we have a couple of choices between these two. I think I want to go ahead and get this going. So we will go to 39.
Ooh, I'm winning.
And crack an Arid Mesa.
Crack, fetch, take 2?
I'm not going to take 2.
But it's modern, isn't it?
That's enough.
Oh.
That's enough. All right, we're going to get a scrub.
Oh, half failing for you.
And I'm going to play Cathar's Crusade.
Cathar's Crusade. If I'm not mistaken, that is from Avacyn Restored?
That is correct.
Huh. So if you play a card such as Increasing Devotion, you'll have 5 6-6s.
Maybe. Maybe not. Hmm. But definitely, actually.
Okay. All right.
We're going to play Cathar's Crusade and pass the turn.
All right. I'm going to draw the card that I tutor for, which is actually in my hand already.
Oh. Cheater. So,
yep.
I'm going to mark the times you cheat. We have 1.
1? The count is at 1. Land Ho.
A land that can mill. How clever.
5. Blue. I will cast Tesare. The seeker. He starts with the 4 low with the counters. And now I either can untap my Artifex, and my accent's changed from French to Russian. I don't know. Or I can tutor. think I'm going to tutor.
I think you're going to tutor minus zero and get nothing.
Minus one.
On. Could we see a soul ring in our future?
Three, four, five. I have a mana. One mana floating?
No.
Yeah.
One, two, three, four, five.
Correct. All right.
So you have no mana floating.
Actually, I'm going to untap two artifacts.
Oh, here we go.
That's two.
Cheating count two.
Two. Storm count, cheat count two. And now I'll play one, two, three,
four, five.
Phenax.
Here he comes.
God of Deception. Note, his name, God of Deception, the acronym is God. But you didn't know that. And I've played my land for the turn.
You have?
Have I? You have five. You went first. Cheats McGee. All right, I'm done.
You have a land?
I pass the turn.
Okay. All right. I will untap and draw, hopefully, a spicy card.
Don't draw a spicy card.
All right, so I think right now, since we're interested in getting rid of old Tezzere, this is going to get us the most tokens, but it's going to be pretty soft to old Chancellor of the Spire over there.
Chancellor of the Spire of the Dragon?
Of the Spires. Okay, so we're going to play a Core Haven that's going to do excellent to prevent all of his combat damage.
Yes, yes.
We're going to play old Grave Daddy.
Grave Daddy?
Grave Daddy.
We're talking about this
guy. Let's get two zombies.
Look how good he is
in
everything.
He's awfully, awfully good. Yeah. Everything staple.
Mm-hmm.
All right, and then we're going to trigger Cathar's Crusade.
Sure.
Each of my creatures.
Which order do you wish to stack these triggers?
Well, I would like to stack the triggers so these come into play. And then they get counters.
Hmm.
I'm not going to allow you to trick me into saying it wrong.
All right. Rats.
But I appreciate the effort.
It got me. The old Hero Blade Hold trick.
Okay. So this is going to have a counter. Three plus three. This is going to have a counter. This is going to have three counters.
Sure.
All right. Arming a can.
Yeah. Got your can.
Part one.
I'm about to get canned.
I will pass the turn.
In your turn, activate Chancellor Spires with his ability granted by Phenax, milling you for seven cards.
One, two. Three, four, five, six, seven.
All right. Did you mill any spells off that?
I did mill Enlightened Tutor and Idyllic Tutor, that's unfortunately.
Not ideal for
to me. Go along with the Academy Rector already in my graveyard.
Draw a card. Ooh, I drew a land. That's just what I wanted. Okay, so I've got some things I can do. My devotion to blue and black is one, two, three, four, five, six, seven.
Seven. Close.
Seven is the number.
Oh, it is seven.
Seven is the number indeed. Yes.
So he is a thing.
He has a thing. Thinking. I have a lot to think about. All right. I think I've got a plan here. Float a colorless.
Oh, no.
Phyrexian Metamorph. I will take two life, pay two life, go to 39.
I have an idea of what you might be copying.
This will copy Chancellor of the Spires.
Mm-hmm.
I will cast Vampiric Tutor again from your graveyard.
Oh my gosh.
As it does not exile it. I know what I'm getting. There it is. Yeah, that one's not bad. So that's going to go on top. So I have a colorless floating, correct?
You do have one colorless floating.
Boop.
What could you possibly do with that colorless?
Well, let's see. This is Minamino mana. So I have four, five mana if I want it. I need six mana. No, I need six mana. If
well, you
need.
Have access to
I
six
I have a lot
mana.
More. So I have one, two, three, four, five, six, seven. Okay, I can play this tapped in. All right, this is what we're going to do. Creeping Tar Pit.
Do your worst. Four mana.
Umbral Mantle.
Okay. You still have one floating.
I do. I will take him up, untapping up to two target artifacts.
All right.
I have one floating. I have a clip Phenax God of Deception with my Umbral Mantle.
This is not going to be good.
It's probably not. All right, I have one floating.
Let me just take a sneak
ahead.
Peek.
Go ahead. Yes. Take a preview of what you're in store for. All right. I will activate Phenax's ability to mill you equal to his toughness, but I will hold priority and pay one, two, three to untap him. And okay. Give him +2/+2 until end of turn.
And now his mill ability resolves, and I will mill 9.
Do
you have any other effects?
Yes. I will do it again. I will hold priority and untap him once more.
Okay.
So you mill 11.
So I'm going to mill 11.
Yes.
All right.
But 11 twice, right?
Correct.
Yes. So 22.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 1, 2.
I guess I could have waited on that cloning the Chancellor Spires for that Demonic Tutor as opposed to an Imperial Tutor. So he's 11, so he can block something at the expense of 4 or more cards from your library. Yeah, I'm going to mill you for 11 more.
Okay. I'm just going to count them out this time.
Sure.
Since we're 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11.
Yeah.
All right, let's take a look at what you got this time.
What did I get this time?
11 more cards is what you got.
Excellent. All right, that's all I got, man.
All right. We'll untap, do our worst.
Oh, I'm not dead.
That one is okay. It's not great. It is not great.
You get milled, man.
I am.
Did you ever think your life would come to this?
I didn't. Hmm. I didn't ever think I was going to have to count my... So, basically, if we allow him to untap with old Phenax, then we are in deep poo-poo.
Old Phenax-y.
So, my plan was going to be this, but Umbra Man will kind of mess things up.
That's probably the first time anyone has uttered
that ever said that. That's probably true. So if we have 7, they all have 7 toughness. That's an awful lot.
How lucky.
Okay, so we're going to play a land. Unfortunately, that gets another card out of my library. So we're going to try to avoid using that one, if possible.
Hope you still have fetch targets left.
Hopefully I do. I'll probably have to check before I go into
We'll just into wake that. Me up.
Before I go?
Yes.
I'll be sure to do that. All right. First things first, I'm going to cast Oblivion Ring.
Oblivion Resolves.
I am going to choose... Let's see. I was actually thinking Mind Stone, but I think I'm going to pass on that one. I think that could be a good one, too. So if we choose Phenax, then he's probably going to tap his 2 creatures rather than blocking, I'd imagine.
Well, this guy doesn't have haste.
Indeed. So his 1 creature. But if we get Umbramantle, we can get rid of any shenanigans that could possibly happen next turn. I think we're going to have to get Umbramantle.
Excellent. Umbramantle has been chosen over my general.
Since the general is going to come back awfully soon. Okay. Yep. And we are going to play Goblin Bombard.
Oh my. All right.
Not too bad.
Yeah,
not too bad.
That's all right.
We're going to need some more room here. I'm going to make some tokens. All right.
Sure.
I'm going to go to my combat
set. You may.
I'm going to attack with all of my creatures. Grave Titan puts 2 more zombies into play.
What?
And guess what?
What?
They're going to trigger some more.
No!
So this guy is going to get 2 counters, and this guy is going to get 2 counters. And these are each going to get 2 more counters.
Let me help you out. All right. All right,
attack.
Well, I'll take 14 and 11.
14 and 11, so we have 7-7. So that's what, 25?
I'm not a math major, just a minor.
Math scientist. All right.
So I'm at 14?
You're at 14.
Mm-hmm.
I'm then going to play...
That wasn't too bad.
Skull Clamp.
Give him the clamps.
Give him the clamps.
Clamp him.
And I will pass the turn.
In your turn, mill you for 7, please.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
I will take my turn now. I will draw the card that I have Empire Tutor.
All right.
Play this land.
Oh, no.
Oh, yes. Hmm. I will start the charades by milling you for 7. How many cards are in your library, sir?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 24.
24.
24.
14, 24. That'll do it. I'll ultimate desert. In response, so I will hold priority and mill you for 7.
Seven more.
Ultimate ability resolve?
It resolves, so that makes all of your
artifacts 5
fives. Gentlemen 5 fives.
Mill you for 5, please. Mill you for 5, please. Mill you for 7, please. Activate Mutavault. Mill you for 2. Untap my Phenax. Mill you for 7. I pass the turn to you, sir. Do with it as you will. Upkeep. Do you have any effects? You might want to crack that.
That's a good point. Mm-hmm. I have a lot of life to work with.
You do. You have tons of life.
So it appears that I'm dead, and I could have almost lived. Well, not almost lived. I could have almost killed him with this last turn rather than playing the Oblivion Ring. But I don't think I would have, so I'm going to go to my draw step.
You may. Right. Victory!
We'll scoop it up for this one.
All right. All right, here we're back again for game 2 of the mill phenomenon sweeping the nation.
And the token phenomenon about to sweep McDarby's life total into the garbage.
Well, I'm about to give you the sweep of 5-7 games to 0. But, you know, I'm on the draw and I have 2 lands, but one's a scry land, so that's how you keep keep hands in standard.
That's how you do it in standard.
That's what you do in standard, so
what could be different?
Wrong?
Yeah. Yeah. All right, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Do you have any pregame effects?
I do not this time.
Excellent. All right. I'm going to lead off with a command tower again and pass the turn.
I will draw this. Nope. Scry land. This card, right now, I would play him and he would die as a state-based effect, so I'm going to put him right there on the bottom.
Excellent. My guess is it's not a land.
It's not.
I'm going to draw. And I believe I'm going to play this guy for 1.
Oh, okay.
Hex
hey,
equals
Mickey,
1.
You're so fine, you blow my mind. Hey, Mickey!
I think
hey,
it's. Hey, I hey, think Mickey. You're so fine, hey. You pump my team.
What are you talking about? That's not the lyrics of the song.
I think it is.
Okay. Well, I drew land. That's a good start. Good start. I'll play land and cast Mind Stone!
No!
You'll go.
All right.
I can play this, but why should I? It doesn't do anything.
I don't think attacking for 1 is going to get me anywhere.
I think that might be the play.
So I'm going to play this tapped and pass the turn yet again.
Yes! I like it when you don't do anything. Ooh, a 7 drop. That's just what I wanted, actually.
Hey, now.
Land. Tap 3. Coalition Relic.
He's still ramping.
I pass the turn.
Stone Cold ramping. I'm going to put another counter on Micaeus.
Get my ramp. It's not on Micaeus. It's on each creature you control.
I'm going to put a counter on Micaeus with a step.
Oh, yes.
All right. Done?
You're correct. I'm done.
Okay. All right. I'm going to play this guy, and I think our plan is going to be do this the next turn. But for now, we're going to play this and attack and get some early damages in.
No!
I believe that's going to be a planeswalker.
All right.
I'm going to attack
5.
For 5 plus 2.
Plus 2, you remembered.
33.
It's like Christmas time. Oh, you remembered. All right.
And I will pass the turn.
I will put a charge counter on my coalition relic.
No. This can only be bad.
Can that be a charge counter? Is that all right with you?
I'll allow it.
All right, untap, upkeep, no effects. Draw. Remove a counter.
Name a color.
I'll name a color. I'll name black.
Exactly what I thought you'd name.
I will play a land.
Just a normal land.
Not just the skirt. The old Scourge of Standard, Nephalia Drownyard. I will cast the following.
Do your worst.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Don't do your worst.
Shaldred Whispering One.
Shh. Not that good against a token deck.
It's terrible.
But you only have 2 creatures right now, so I thought it'd be good.
That's probably right.
Now I'll cast Shield Sphere. And end the turn.
trigger, please, sir.
Well, I don't know exactly what I'm going to do.
Ah.
Now, I could do this for one, but I don't know how good that really is. Actually, I do. Hmm. It's not good.
Not good. Well, yeah, but it's Phenax, Guard of Deception.
It's true.
You have no good options.
It's not good at all. What I really need to do is find a way to get my mana to a point where I can cast this card. Hmm. And I feel like I'm going to be in pretty good shape if we can do that. So I am going to do this for one. It's going to draw me a card. So during my upkeep, I'm going to cycle Decree of Justice for one. Put a soldier into play.
Decree of Justice.
And I'm going to draw a card.
Okay.
His ability resolves.
Her ability.
Its ability.
Touché. So
we can't be sure.
Well, only planeswalkers have genders associated with them on card text.
Excellent.
But you didn't know that.
Excellent
did you?
To know.
But you didn't know that.
Excellent to know.
Gary Finalis, deal damage to him.
All right. I'm going to go to my draw step.
You may.
Okay, so. This Shield Ward's actually going to be tough to get around for the next couple of turns.
Even though you're playing the all token all the time deck.
Despite the all token all the time. So we're just going to play a Scalding Tarn and
attack?
Pass the turn.
Might not block.
Not attack.
I have a wall. Trigger, I have nothing.
Okay.
Alright. Hmm. Hmm. So close to casting this one, but alas, earwax. Do or do not. There is no try. I can do these two, or this one. Or my general.
General?
Generalissimo. Yeah, and I can charge my relic for next turn, so let's do that. That sounds good. Five. General! He's not a creature,
there
but it's
is.
Okay. I'm done.
Thank goodness. Okay. End of turn, I'm going to put a counter on Micaeus.
Resolves.
Excellent. I'm also going to...
Take three?
I'm not going to take three.
Why not? This is
modern,
isn't
it? I'm going to go to 39.
All your cards are modern except for those swamps. Some delicious, delicious swamps.
Delicious. And I'm going to get a Sacred Foundry.
His tasty, tasty courage. Oh, Sacred Foundry. The chains, chain to the rocks invitational card.
If we can find it, we found it.
Found it. Have you been to Ironforge before? It looks like Ironforge.
It does. I'm a fan of this art.
Yeah, it's all right.
I prefer it over the old art. In
Do
fact,
you?
I think I prefer most of the new Shockland art.
Steam Mints?
No, not
Didn't
that one.
Think so.
You caught me.
Yeah.
You caught me. But most of the other ones.
Overgrown Tomb?
Neither here nor there on either one. I don't think either of them are that great. Okay.
Trigger. Oh, I ain't gonna forget, y'all.
I ain't gonna forget.
Sorry, that's my Stephen Grain impression.
All right, so again, we have another option to keep Micaeus in play.
He's so fine.
Or Hellrider, we can toss.
Would you ride my Hellrider?
Either way, we're kind of going to be in some trouble.
I like this card in my hand because it says Jace on it. I like Jace. Mm.
Okay, so I think we're going to go ahead and get rid of Hellrider this turn.
Excellent.
All right. Draw my card. That's not awful. Not great.
You need something.
Not awful.
You need something good.
I will play an Urza's Factory.
Oh, no, I need that in my deck. Mm.
Indeed you
the
do.
The land makes tokens?
So since we're going to try to get to this,
I
think we want to go ahead and play this card rather than this one. Because I don't know how much we're going to get out of just playing this and trying to fight his mill army.
My mill army.
So all
right.
We're going to cast...
Yeah, I've got one too.
Oh my gosh!
Yours from Future Sight, though.
It is.
Mine's from Dual Decks. Phyrexia versus the Coalition.
That means yours only makes one mana every other turn.
What?
Well, I'm sorry, that's how the world works.
Oh.
All right. I have nothing else.
You're done?
And I will pass the turn.
I'll mill you for 12,
oh,
please, sir.
Oh my gosh. 1, 2, 3, 4.
I don't
four.
Need to attack. I've evolved
one, two, three,
beyond
four,
attacking.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Let's see what goodies you got. Enlightened Tutor yet again.
Skull Clamp.
Skull Clamp and Vampiric Tutor.
Which Vampiric Tutor Justice. Probably would go for Skull Clamp that a lot.
You could.
Charge counter.
Maybe not in this matchup.
Yep. Trigger. You know the back. Yeah. I will add the following blue. So my guy's still not a creature yet. That's weird.
Still not a creature. I feel like last game,
one,
he became
two,
a creature
three,
much
four,
quicker than it would seem.
5-6. I will cast Jace's Mindseeker. I like Jace. I dress up as him sometimes.
Interesting.
Will you please mill the top 5 cards of your library? And if there's an instant or sorcery among them, I can cast them. Idyllic Tutor.
This is an excellent.
I'll cast.
You'll choose this.
I'll
excellent.
Choose that.
All right. You've chosen March
no?
of Souls?
I know.
You
didn't,
have chosen March
not
of
the
Souls.
Misclick.
The real life misclick.
Let's right. see if I have any enchantments in my deck. I'm not actually sure if I do. My commander's an enchantment. But I don't know if I have any enchantments
I'm
in my
sure
deck.
I'm sure there's one. There's one hiding in there somewhere.
Oh, there's one.
Oh, no. 7 toughness.
Look at that. 7 toughness seems to be a thing. There's one.
There does seem to be a theme between all of your enchantments. But I can't quite put my finger on what it is.
I think it's the card type.
Mm.
Yep, those are my two
enchantments. That's probably not it. I think it's because they're all holding weapons.
That might be it. No, they're from Theros.
Mm, that could be it, too. Mm. I see no other similarities.
I get both of them, right?
I don't think so.
No? Okay, let's see. My devotion to blue is currently 3.
Well, I hope he doesn't get Erebos because I really need to gain life in this matchup.
Hey. He mills for more. But I have less black devotion after this card. Interesting decision. I think I gots to get this one. Because it's God of the Sea. Gots.
You gots to get
God,
it?
God of the Sea. It's an acronym. So yeah, I'll do that. And
you look like you want to attack for 0. No, you can't attack. That's a wall. Attack for 6.
I'll play Mikokoro, and I'm done.
Okay. I'll put a charge counter on Coalition Relic.
That ability resolves.
I will put a 1-1 counter on the case.
That ability also resolves.
Excellent. Excellent.
Hey, yeah, there we go.
Bye, Macias. This is still here.
Bye, Mickey. He did so much work.
He
know?
Really did. He got in all 3 damage.
He was the workhorse really for your deck. Surprisingly, workhorse and the other Macias, quite the combo.
Interesting. All right. I'll go to my draw.
Mm-hmm.
White mana.
Out of here. You casting Elishnorn?
No. Why would I cast Elishnorn? Well, getting 1 extra token doesn't do me a whole lot. So we're just going to get 5. And cast Marshall Kahu.
My creatures.
They're gone.
Phenax is still around.
They are all gone.
Hmm.
Excellent.
Hmm. I'm going to mill you in response.
Oh, all right. Cheat count at 3?
Yep. Mill you for
12?
12, yeah, still 12. The guy doesn't have
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. What do we have this time, boys and girls? More cards, including Academy Rectair.
Okay. Hardly newer.
I will pass the turn.
Charge counter.
Phenax still hanging around.
Main way, he's in a short
doesn't
pool.
Have very many friends this time.
I will add blue, I suppose. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, perhaps?
Mayhaps.
I will play Draw Isle of Refuge. I will gain a life.
Okay. 34.
Yeah. What do you know about that? 1, 2, 3... Alley mirror.
That's the most adorable mirror I've
he
ever
really
seen.
He really is so cute. And then I will tap 3, blue mana, Thassa, God of the Sea.
Surprising.
2 gods. Yeah, that's all I got, man. Yeah. Right?
I believe so. Either way.
What was this mana for?
You cast alloy mirror.
I have mana out for that.
Oh, interesting. You can untap.
I'll play 3 mana then and cast Rings of Brighthearth.
Interesting. That's probably a pretty good one.
I'm done. Note, I have Metalcraft.
I'm going to put a counter on Coalition.
Fortunately, all my creatures aren't really creatures.
They're not, except for old Alloy Mir.
Mir, Mir.
He's just adorable. Mir. All right. Shieldred. Oh! That's in the graveyard now.
No. Well, wouldn't do much right now anyway.
True. I'll go to my draw. So, since we have 8 mana, I'm going to cast both of these.
Don't do it.
I'm going to do it.
What color do you choose?
I'm going to choose red.
Probably at least
I'm going to choose red. Most likely. Honestly, it doesn't really matter what I'm going to choose.
But I'm going to cast Purpose.
Martin.
Oh, no.
Stromgold. More like Stromgold. Strong. He's real strong. That's all I know.
Strong bully?
He or she.
I'm hungry.
Okay.
That's my Danny West impression. I'm hungry.
I'm also going to play Sorin.
The Lord?
Lord of Innistrad. All right.
That's fine.
I'm going to have a Sorin emblem.
Oh, yes.
I don't think we have any way to show that we have a Sorin emblem.
We can have Arulax be a Sorin emblem. He's kind of like an emblem.
How about this? Because we might have more.
Okay.
We might have more later. All we right. might also have fairy tokens. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler alert.
Okay. I'm going to attack.
Yeah. They're all 2-1s, eh?
They're all 2-1s.
Guess I'm taking 10.
You look like it.
24.
24.
Yep. That's all you got.
I will pass the turn.
For any kids back at home, if they don't know what Martin Stromgold does, it'd be bad if he attacked. Let's just put it that. Scry 1. That doesn't do anything for me. Kind of like a land and a creature. Yeah, I'll keep it in. I'll keep it up there.
Okay, all right.
I'll draw a card. Was there a charge counter? There wasn't.
We've whittled him down.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Phyrexian Jester.
I believe you exile a creature.
I do. He's kind of like Duplicant, except he can.
Duplicant.
I'll exile him.
Interesting. You're going to get +1/+1.
I get plus X plus Y.
Oh.
X is his power and Y is his toughness. If I just divide by the antiderivative and take the hypotenuse, then I have the Pythagorean theorem.
Of exactly a 1/1 counter.
Snake Eyes. So he's exiled. Hounf. But he can hound wherever he wants.
Whole hump over.
And I will enter.
Why do we have two?
X plus Y.
Okay.
X is one, Y is one.
Sure.
I'm just following the card, man.
I suppose so.
Combat. I will attack the Lord with Alamir.
Sorin is gone.
Well, that's
we're
going to
put him sideways in my graveyard so we can remember we got an emblem.
Okay, I'm done.
Sounds good.
That's all I got, man. My devotion to blue is currently 3. And my devotion to black is 1.
A little lacking.
Yeah.
It's Let's draw.
Building the artifact-centric devotion deck. It's not working out well for me. It's weird.
So, this was an interesting draw. By interesting, probably pretty good.
Oh, no.
Probably pretty good. So I think the first thing, we can't cast all of these, so we're just going to cast this one.
Stop casting.
So something bad doesn't happen later. All right. I am going to attack.
I will block one of them with my 5/5. 4/4.
All right. You're 4/4.
And I'll take 8?
You'll take 8. You go to 16.
That's really low.
It is.
Why?
And then I'm going to cast this card that we were talking about in the intro video. Ritual of the Machine.
Huh.
I'm going to sacrifice a soldier.
Alright.
And I'm going to gain control of Phyrexian Jester. I'm not sure why I didn't do that pre-combat.
Well, okay, it turned out the same damage either, anyway.
No, not really.
Oh yeah, you're down a guy.
Yep.
That's okay, I'm not good at magic either.
Sure. Excellent.
So you got?
And I will pass the turn after
Card counter. My devotion has been lessened. Upkeep, scry 1. That's so close to being good. I guess I'll take it and try not to die for this turn. I will draw it. I will add a black. I didn't even look at this graveyard, but whatever. What's the worst that could happen?
What's the worst that could happen? Oh my.
Let's hope you have creatures in your graveyard, because I actually don't know if you do or not. 1, 2, 3, 4. Solomon Grundy.
He's Simulacron.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, man, that's all I got.
All right.
Don't kill me.
I'm gonna put a charge counter on Coalition Relic.
Don't kill me, please, Justin Parnell, Cube Man.
So we have an Alloy Mirror that can tap to mill 2.
Meow meow.
And that's about it.
Meow.
All right.
A
let's
mirror
draw.
Alloy Mirror.
A mirror Alloy Mirror.
That Rings of Brandhearth hasn't really done much for me.
It has done exactly nothing. I'm going to make a white mana.
How many creatures do you have in here?
With Coalition Relic. Let me check it out.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Hey, not bad. Thank you, Sheldon.
Pretty good.
Mm-hmm.
Shieldred really put a damper on my plans this game.
Well, you're not doing that bad.
I think it's about to get bad. I think Eater of the Dead might...
Eat your dead?
He may or may not eat my dead.
Bring out your dead.
Well, I think we want to get as much as we can off of this, so...
I'm not dead yet.
Rather than playing either of these two cards, which aren't really going to do anything in the next turn, this is the only one that is, so we're going to cast White Sun Zenith. For...
Cat.
Five.
I'm a kid to cat.
And shuffle it back into my library.
Well, no! The anti-mill deck.
All right, so I'm not sure we have any kitties. Any kitty cats.
What are kitty cats at, yo?
We're going to try to find some kitty cats.
Well, he's a cool cat. Until kitties come in the range, BBD will be a cool cat.
Okay, so while we're getting kitty cats, mm-hmm. I have no choice but to attack with my creatures.
Your creatures? I think I might block with Alley Mirror. Yep. I will block Phyrexian Jester with Alley Mirror.
Okay.
And then I will use his ability. See, I could put a charge counter on this and clone it with Rings of Brightheart to have two charge counters, because it's not technically a mana ability. But I think the two milling might be relevant, since that's kind of how I win all these games.
Oh, I doubt it.
Yeah, I'll block him, and you're taking me for six? Yeah. And I'll mill you for two.
Okay. So I'm going to be milled for two.
Hopefully with creatures.
Oh, that was
a good one. That was a good one to get out of there. All
right. That was a good one.
So I'll take six, correct?
You're going to take six and go to 10.
Yeah, man.
All right. We have some cats.
Meow.
And BBD.
BBD. I like him. He's a good guy.
All right. Well, that's about all I got.
That's all you got, man?
All right. Let's see what happens next turn.
All right. Put charge counter on this. Upkeep. I will put Thassa, God of the Seas, triggered ability onto the stack. Does it resolve?
Yes, it does.
Thank you. I will scry. Well, it's land, so I don't need that. It's kind of what her ability always does.
And then lands? No, I don't think so.
Draw a card. Ooh, I drew a land.
Yes. Was it a better land? No, it was not.
All right. Eater of the Dead. Let's
all right, here we go.
Done, eh? All right. Mill you for four.
No, there's that White Sun Zenith again.
Let's just, got it. That'll teach you to shuffle it. Just keep your deck in your hand. That's okay. A very common thing I know for you.
Well... How am I going to keep my graveyard in my hand also?
Okay, I will untap Eater of the Dead, exiling...
The top creature? How about that?
A creature. No, Hellrider.
The bottom creature.
Yep. First to die, first to get eaten. Get added. Eaten.
Okay.
I will activate his ability, milling you for four.
All right.
I will untap it, eating Mikaius the Lunark.
Where is Mikaius?
I don't know. He better be in there.
I found him.
Ah, yes. Now I will mill you for four more. I will eat Fusion Commander.
Oh, no.
The newly revealed Fusion Commander, and mill you for four more.
Oh, no.
Oh, Danny West, eat your heart out.
Don't do it.
Eat her.
Oh, God.
Oh, now I'll mill you for four more. What should you get for playing with the Elgin?
No.
Grave Titan, I'll eat that one, too, and I'll mill you for four more.
All right, come on, miss. All right.
Okay, there's another creature in there. I'll eat one of those.
You're going to eat Twilight Drover.
Ooh, now I'll mill you for again. Are we having fun yet?
No, we're not. Oh. No creatures on that one.
I will untap eating Martain Strong. Oh, you're gonna get it.
He's gone.
Who else?
We have an Emiria
Angel.
Yeah,
I'll eat that one. Not melee for four more.
All right, no creatures.
There has to be one more creature. There has to be creatures in there.
There's gotta be. You would think.
Give me a creature. I need a creature. Glamour
Ranger. Oh, man.
Yeah, we got a chunk of creatures.
There's a chunk here.
All right, let me get some chunk out of the chunks. Eat Cloudguard Ranger. I hate that card. Cedric, I'm sorry.
Four?
Million for four, yeah.
All right, we hit a Geist Hunter Monk.
I'll eat that one. And mill you again. Seems like we're having a good time here. I'll eat Captain of the Watch. Mill you.
No. Purphoros.
Purphoros. I will activate Mistress Factory.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll mill you for two. I will then mill you for three with Nephalia Drowneer. I will now tap Psalm to mill you for two. I will then untap Ear of the Dead, targeting my Halomir. And I mill myself for three.
For four.
For four. All right, you're good.
Interesting. Well.
Well.
Unfortunately, we did not live through the turn.
Well, heck, man.
We had to mill exactly zero creatures off of our first six. Didn't happen.
Didn't happen.
So it looks like we are again dead.
You have been milled.
Milled again. Eater of the Dead, man, that is a...
Eater of the Dead is a strong card.
So it seems like, through two games, cards that can untap and mill again might not be so bad.
Might not be so bad.
Pretty good.
I'm sure.
All right, we're back for game three of the milling sensation. This is for all the people out there that always make fun of mill and say it's terrible, and well, it is pretty bad. In 1v1 Commander with Phenax, Eater of the Dead, and Umber Mantle in your deck, how
not
could you possibly
too bad.
Lose? You can never lose.
Well, hasn't happened so far.
It won't happen again.
All right. Well, let's see if we can get something going. Our hand is okay. We see this guy again, but I feel like we have the right mix of spells and lands this time.
I also have three lands and four spells. The four spells can be put in any Commander deck, though.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm.
All right. I'm going to lead off with a Windbrisk Heights.
Windbrisk Heights.
Could be awfully good. Well, this is about the simplest Windbrisk Heights I've ever seen.
Is it three lands and a spell?
This is going to be the choice.
Is that a spell?
I don't know.
I will draw this card. The Sol Ring.
Nope. Spoiler alert, not a land.
Demir Guildgate. You'll go.
All right. Untap, draw. That was not a bad one. Not a bad one at all. We are going to...
That draw step is pretty cruel.
Play Fetid Heath into a Rakdos Signet.
Yes.
We'll pass a turn.
I'm going to draw this card. And I'm going to play this card. The Valley Drown Yard. Erusionist Blazers.
Yep.
Here we go.
All right. We'll untap and draw. Then we're going to play Sorin,
no!
Lord
a turn
of
three
Innistrad.
Planeswalker.
That's pretty good.
Did you do your mana correctly?
All right. We'll assume that I did.
All right.
Let's do this. Let's
sure,
make black
man.
And white.
It doesn't matter if it's black or white.
We'll make a vampire.
Ba-da-ba-da-ba-da.
A vampire.
I am not the vampire.
I am not the vampire.
Is my goal?
I will pass the
I will
turn.
Draw a card. I'm probably going to die to that Sorin. Play Mikokoro and play the Palladium Mirror, followed by Shield Sphere.
That's a lot of things and stuff.
I'm done. Note, I have Metalcraft.
New, here. Again. Metalcraft for the second time.
Mm-hmm.
All
second
right.
Second time for not the last time.
Well, it's tempting to play this, but I think we're going to wait until next turn. Mm. So, right now, we're going to play this tap, so next turn we can have this. First, we'll scry.
Oh,
let's
scry,
see if we can
scry me a river.
See if we can scry up. Well, we're going to put that on the bottom.
What was
land.
It? Oh. Was it a Graven Cairns?
Was it a Graven Cairns?
I don't know.
It's not. It's not a Graven Cairns.
I don't care anyway.
I don't Cairns.
My
and
cards.
We are going to play Intangible Virtue.
I feel like you're playing a block deck.
I don't see what you mean. All right. I'll make another vampire.
Okay, Des.
And I'm going to attack you.
For two?
For two.
Yeah, I'll take two, I guess.
Okay.
38,
and I'll go to 42, because they have lifelink.
Yes.
And I know you're probably going to kill me with damage, so we got to be really careful.
You watch out, man. My go?
It is your go.
Here I go. I hope I draw something good. That was like the worst draw step my deck could possibly ever make.
Excellent. Excellent. You're really close to casting it. However, you have one, two, three, four colorless mana.
Yes.
One colored mana.
Hey, I'm not racist. All right. So I'll tap for five mana.
Everyone's a little bit racist.
It's true. Everyone's as racist as you.
That is racist.
All right, Batterskull, BBD, join the team. And
join the party.
Attack Sorin with my Shield Sphere.
Oh my gosh. I don't think walls can attack.
It doesn't say that. It doesn't say defender anywhere.
I believe it says counts as a wall.
That is a creature type. It doesn't
I'm
mean
sorry.
Anything. All right, that's all I got, man.
I would love for you to do that, but I'll...
I can equip my Germ with the bracers, and then I could bounce it twice to my hand.
You can. That'd be a powerful play.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Let me read this jobber.
Well, this is going to be okay later.
Yep. All right, that's probably going to be me. It's okay. I have Sadistic Sacrament. You can't possibly win.
I will take two. Go to 40.
It'll be years before you can beat me.
And I am going to play Tempt with Vengeance. X equals 5. Now.
Yes. Yes.
I have a proposition.
You do you? Please.
Would you like to put 5/1/1s into play?
I mean...
You have the option.
I have the option.
It seems like it could be pretty good. I don't know. I'm just saying.
I think this is a rotten deal.
Oh, I don't know. It's
I feel
awfully
like
tempting.
This is really bad for me. But yeah, what the heck? I like tokens. Where's the tokens?
All right, let's find some tokens over here.
Okay. Well, actually, I don't want them.
You don't want the tokens?
No.
All right, you're reneging on the tokens.
Yes.
Okay. Well, let's get five elemental tokens here. I believe they're going to look like our good friend Christopher Van Meter.
I've never heard of him. Is he like live in Europe, or like metric system or something?
Sounds like it. Mm-hmm. All right.
So we have turned commander versus into select versus, I believe.
It looks like it.
Mm-hmm.
So if I attack and he blocks, nothing's pretty much going to happen. So I don't really want to do that.
Probably attack then.
Sounds like I should probably not attack. I'm going to put another vampire
seems
in
like you're working
onto
toward,
the battlefield.
Toward an ultimate of some sort.
I don't know what you could be talking about.
All right.
And do these have haste? Oh, they do have haste. Well, this one does not.
Mm-hmm.
But since they have haste.
Well, these don't either.
Well, they don't have haste.
They don't.
I'm going to attack with vigilance with all of my tokens.
I guess I'll block a token, a vampire.
A vampire.
Vampire.
So you're going to gain.
I take out those two.
And you're
so
going to
take
eight, go to 30.
That's really low.
It seems like it is a little low.
All right.
Well, we'll pass the turn.
All right, I need Cyclonic Rift and two extra mana. Well, that doesn't do anything. At all. Things are looking rough for old House Demir over here. I need a land drop. All right, each player draw a card.
Oh, man.
Yeah, I'm milling you for one.
All that I want.
Now I will pay two and cast Mind Stone.
This game is getting out of hand.
It really is.
I wonder.
Attack you for four. Attack Soren for four.
Attack Soren for four?
Yeah, Soren over California.
Okay.
I gain four.
You do. You're at 34.
I end my turn.
All right. What is the best thing we could draw?
Probably
Elsinore. That's right. The best thing we could draw might be under Windbrisk Heights.
What? No. No. What is it?
Oh, wait. What? We have something else to cast before.
Don't.
I'm going to activate Rakdos Signet and activate Temple of Malice.
You
play Hellrider.
All right. That ain't nothing.
All right. We're going to make a Sorin Emblem.
So you have two Sorin Emblems.
No, just one.
Okay, just one.
That was from last game.
Oh, yeah. This. Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
We are going to go to our combat step.
I will allow it, I guess, begrudgingly.
Right. I'm going to attack with all of these creatures with Vigilance.
I'm going to block.
Plus this.
No, I'm going to block.
Un Momento.
I'm going to block.
This trigger must go on the stack.
No.
It has to. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So you're going to take 8 first.
I mean, if you really want to. If you really... Why are you so mean to me?
It's in my nature.
Huh.
Before blockers.
No, I'm going to block.
Before blockers,
block.
We're going to activate Windbrisk Heights.
Block! Don't do it! That was Norn! Just for the record, I believe it was a called shot. Just so everyone knows. Danny's beating me. He's not even here and he's beating
me. It's true.
All right, that's
now,
fine.
Now, I'm no math scientist, but I think all of these creatures have 5 power.
It seems to be that way.
And I believe Palladium Mirror is in the graveyard.
He may be no more. But my other creatures are alive. All right, I will block Hellrider with BBD and a Vampire with Shield Sphere.
Okay, so you're going to block these.
Mm-hmm. Just
you're going to gain 2 life.
Yep, I'm going to go to 24. And then it's my turn.
Well, you were at you're at 34, so you're actually going to go to 28.
No.
And then you're going to take 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30.
30?
Okay, so that puts you to -2.
Yep.
Okay.
Yep, Michael.
Excellent. Any other effects?
No.
Okay. I believe your token's dead.
Yes, Brian is.
And Shield Sphere.
And me.
All right. Excellent. All right. Well, as anticipated, Elishnorn. Quite the magic card.
No, I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, it looks like you've scooped, so either way.
No. I was just reorganizing my lands.
Okay.
You've scooped.
I've scooped.
Can I get a judge over here? All right, guys, welcome to our conclusion of the 4-7 battle.
Unfortunately.
I came out on top. You see there's two up there. That means I won 2 games.
Only one there.
Only one over there.
One with an asterisk.
What was the asterisk?
So in game 1, I think I could have possibly killed you.
Really?
Had I just played the Elspeth Tariel in my hand.
Yeah.
Given all my creatures 3 more counters.
Mm-hmm.
Attack with Gravetide, given all my creatures 2 more counters.
Mm-hmm.
You likely would have only blocked Gravetide.
Likely,
not necessarily. That's why I could have won.
Could have.
Which would have brought you exactly to 8 life.
And you had and the I bombardment. Would have
goblin bombardment that would have played post-combat to deal you exactly 8 damage.
8 damage. Well,
but that's not how it went.
Good thing you're not good at magic.
That's
or
true.
Been dead.
That's why we're in the Commander.
Commander versus. Yeah, so how do you like playing Commander for your first time? Cube enthusiast, Justin
This
Parnell.
Is my first time playing Commander in probably 6 years.
So back then it was probably the formerly known artist of EDH.
EDH.
Yes.
Yes, correct. It's, you know, had to get my feet wet a little bit. I felt like I was definitely at a disadvantage not using Terrible. I mean Tariel.
Tariel, of course, yeah.
You know, I wish there was a general that was more suited to this deck style.
Yeah,
but really, there's
tokens.
Only there's only three. There's Oros, which mm-hmm. is just as bad as Tariel.
Yeah.
And Kalia, which is very good, but doesn't really go along with the theme of the deck at all.
Yeah, well, most token decks are green and white and X or something. You decided to break that road.
I can't play Goblin Bombardment and Porphyros.
You're correct.
Without playing red.
Yeah, that's true. See, he knows how to play Commander. You know the rules. That's good.
That's true.
Yeah. But coming from your cube mentality into Commander mentality,
yep.
making a Commander deck is about like making your own cube. You got 100 cards. So instead of like 600 or 400, 360 or whatever, you have 100 cards and you make your own environment for you to play with.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the tricky thing is you don't always, people don't play to win as hard as they might do cube.
That's true.
Yeah. So you kind of got to work through that weird social contract, like playing with your friends. At least in theory, people play Commander with their friends. I don't know. I just play here. With these people, these losers.
Yeah, that's true.
You know, but yeah, it's a different kind of mentality. But it is, it's in that big casual format umbrella that we all pertain to.
It is, it is. Mm-hmm. You know, and there's a lot of crossover cards. Yeah. Cards that are good in cube are good in commander, and vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
You know, I'm sure playing commander more, I might find some cards that could be good for cube that I hadn't considered before.
That's good. They keep printing cards that are bad in both formats too, like True Name Nemesis.
That's true. Mm-hmm. What a terrible, terrible magic card.
Yeah. They make a. They're going to keep making new cards for both our formats so we can both live in harmony.
Absolutely.
Yeah,
I think even the summer multiplayer products they've mm-hmm. released, Commander, Plane Chase, this summer is Conspiracy, which is definitely going
and
to be geared
cube
towards
one.
Cube.
That is
and
a
not
cube
necessarily
one.
Geared towards Cube, but obviously a limited format.
Mm-hmm.
And some of the cards I've spoiled so far seem pretty sweet, so I have high hopes
that
both formats could get some pretty sweet stuff.
Yep. Hopefully you guys enjoyed this video with me. Of course you enjoyed it with me, but with Justin Parnell.
Hopefully you'll want me back. Maybe I'll come back to battle McDarby in the future.
Let us know if you want him back. Danny West is out like in Asheville or something.
Somewhere in the deep woods of North Carolina.
Yeah, I'm not really sure what he's doing, but in theory he'll be back. I think he finally beat me the last time, so he's off running.
Right off in the sunset.
Right off in the sunset, yeah. But hope you guys enjoyed the Mill Fantastical Devotion deck that was Phenax. For all those Mill players out there.
And the terrible token deck that was Tariel.
Hey, you won a game.
That's true.
You know, it's like bad players can be good players in Magic. That's why the game's so popular.
I have a feeling we're not going to be seeing the last of this deck. We might we might tinker with it a little bit and come back somewhere down the line and see where we are.
Let us know what you guys think about it below, and we'll catch you next time.
Thanks, guys.